Hey you guys, Muad'Dib here. So today I'm gonna bring you the top 10 rarest items in World of Warcraft. Number 1, Haunted Memento. This one's unique. It's not a pet nor a toy. It's pretty much a worthless item that summons an undead buddy who follows you around. Why is it rare then you may ask? The item was only available during Wrath of the Lich King's launch event back in 2009. When the Scourge attacked Azeroth, so people either forgot about it, destroyed it years ago, or they were lucky enough to still have it in their bank. Now it goes for hundreds of thousands of gold on the auction house. Number 2, Chromatic Sword. The sword's a popular transmog because it's the only item with a rainbow glow, but there's a tiny problem. It's no longer in the game and can only be found on the auction house. Before Cataclysm, the sword had a 26% chance drop rate from a rare and stranglethorn called Scale Belly. It was constantly farmed by collectors, and some people created death knights to plant them at Scale Belly's spawn point. But Cataclysm changed the zone, and Scale Belly is now a low level monster with a whole different loot table, meaning that the chromatic sword no longer drops. The only place to find one is on the auction house, but even if it shows up, it's very pricey. Number 3, Talisman of the Binding Shard. As far as I know, this item was not intended to drop, but there was one lucky warrior named Nocton. He was the first and only person in the game to ever get this drop. When this item is equipped, a lightning ball will circle around the player just as a shaman's lightning shield would. Who knows why this item was placed in the game. Number 4, Trading Card Game, Mounts, Pets, and Toys. Items from WoW's trading card game, loot cards, are among the most treasured and they're highly sought after. However, it was never as easy to get them as it is today. Besides the auction house, they constantly appear on the black market auction house. The most popular ones are the Swift Spectral Tiger, the Magical Rooster, and the X-51 Nether Rocket Extreme due to their unique appearance, but whether it's a pet, toy, or mount, they'll go for a gold cap all the time, and even if you have the money, you still need to bid in time to win. Number 5, Dirge's Kickin' Chimera Chops. Dirge's recipe is a cooking reward from a removed quest chain that pops up on the auction house from time to time. It was removed with Cataclysm, so it isn't as old as the Thistle Tea, but it's the only epic quality cooking recipe in the game. Number 6, Extorthian Firestick. Back in the day, World of Warcraft had all these strange class quests. For instance, Warlocks once needed to complete a long quest chain to unlock their epic mount, and to do that they needed to go to Dire Maul with a party and kill an optional boss only they could summon. That wasn't a huge deal because the boss had its own loot table, which included this cool imperial inspired firearm that hunters could pick up off the corpse. Here's the thing though, the quest is now gone from the game, and the only people who can still summon the boss are those who completed it back when it was available. Obviously, as the years pile on, there are fewer and fewer warlocks around Azeroth who have that kind of pedigree. If you do find somebody willing to make that run with you, please reward them handsomely. Number 7, Zin'rokh, Destroyer of Worlds. Also, Destroyer of Sanity and Time, because it is so rare, this one's an archaeology reward for solving troll dig sites. Some archaeology mounts are pretty rare, but there's nothing compared to this weapon, and it's bind to account, so you have to solve projects until it pops up. There's no other way to obtain it, but it just won't happen. It's 1 in a 1500 chance. Number 8, Brawler's Harness. This is a cruel joke, really. The Brawler's Harness is a skimpy leather strap shirt that level 1 trolls, undead, and orcs found in their bags upon creating their character back in the early days of World of Warcraft. It was as close as a gnaw value item that you could get, considering it was literally gifted to you upon spawning. No leveling, no grinding, no money required. However, after the Cataclysm expansion, the Brawler's Harness was retired. It is no longer given out to newbies or otherwise obtainable, making this model extremely rare. Number 9. Miner's Hat of the Deep. Contrary to popular belief, this helmet is still obtainable in-game. It also just so happens to be unreasonably rare from random trash mobs inside the OG leveling dungeon Alderman. I've heard delirious war stories about endless farm runs that continually turn up empty. So, why the fuss? Well, the Miner's Hat of the Deep equips a candle on your character's forehead, making it one of the most unique models in Warcraft. It is also bind on equipped, which means it routinely fetches over 5 million gold on the auction house. So, after about 500 consecutive Alderman clears, I'm sure you'll find your own. Good luck. Number 10. Pendulum of Doom. We're not done with Aldum yet, because somehow that dungeon has another rare drop that caught the eyes of inspiring transmoggers. I give you the Pendulum of Doom, a lowly two-handed axe with a scarlet engrave on the blade. The drop rate is so extremely low, let's be optimistic and say you get it within the next 250 runs. Well guys, that's the 10 rarest items in WoW. Hopefully you enjoyed. Thank you for watching. Give me some feedback on it. I appreciate it.